Hi, I'm Mal Millie, here with your CUES tip. Today we're going to be talking about the proper wheel torque for your compact pipe ranger. To start, we're going to set this unit up for a 10-inch pipe and go through exactly the process. We'll remove our 6-inch wheel. Whenever removing the wheels, we always want to make sure there's no debris in the area before setting up for the next pipe size. So check around, maybe brush it off. For the 10-inch setup, we're going to be using our 1-inch spacer. Before putting our spacer on, we want to make sure we have anti-seize on the axles. Flush it across. We use anti-seize for any metal-on-metal contact. Anti-seize prevents galling when dissimilar metals come together. Drop the spacer into place and you'll feel it lock. Before we set the wheel on the spacer, we'll apply anti-seize again. Set the wheel in place and feel it lock. We'll dress the head of our screw with just a little bit of anti-seize. And drop it into place. For our compact pipe ranger, we specify 15 foot-pounds of torque because it keeps the wheel secure to the transporter body, but is safe for the screw heads and the axle. We do have other transporters with different torque settings, but the CPR takes 15 foot-pounds of torque. It's important to use a torque wrench set to 15 foot-pounds, and if possible, your factory supplied torque wrench. If you don't have a factory supplied torque wrench, another torque wrench will do, but it's best to use the factory supplied one. When the wrench clicks twice, you'll know you've reached the appropriate setting. Compact pipe ranger set up for a 10-inch pipe.